All right, this will be kind of fun just to mess around. But out of curiosity, I'm also sitting, which is why I don't know if you can actually tell, but it is cool. They actually do the, wow. Okay, that's impressive. They actually do the look around type VR. There's, I don't know what the terminology is called, but there's like static VR, where if you move, you're not actually moving in the world. They didn't do that here. So actually, wow, they actually did a good job here. But what I wanted to do is a little experiment. I told you who I think the most attractive girl is. From looks. Let's see, just out of curiosity, let's get into the story, have fun, and let's see which one I naturally become more in tune with. I'm kind of curious myself. Plus, I want to tell you I'm kind of pissed off, I'm trying to calm down. I fucking went by the internet, and it turns out Danganronpa 3 was recordable. I'm on chapter 1, about to get to the first murder trial, and it's still letting me record, so I'm kind of pissed. But I'm not going to restart that entire amount and pretend I never saw it. I don't want to do that with you guys, so we're just going to play all kinds of stuff, have fun, and to be fair, I couldn't put Ultra Despair Girls out anyway, so I couldn't put the whole series on the channel if I wanted to. So, as if she'd picked up on my gut feel, Tagoku steps forth with an uneasy expression. She's always laughing her head off, so whenever she looks serious, we know that things are headed in a bad direction. And I'm sitting, so I shouldn't be angry over everything. Could I have a moment with everyone? What the fuck's that look on her face? Yu is giving a weird looking face. She also looks kind of terrified, like this isn't common. And her, I can again impose a penis in there. Okay. Photoshop a penis. Yuria. Fucking. Shut up, redhead. If you are. I don't know who any of you are. None of you have real hair colors. Except maybe her. Hers is kind of like, I could picture Blackpink wearing a fucking hair color. Whatever. Everyone quiets down and waits for Tagoku to continue. Her tone of voice doesn't have its usual playful cheer. Rather, it carried with it a grave seriousness. Okay, do it. Oh my god, it's just, I want a VR hentai game. Okay. Okay. Something you need to talk about? What? It's pretty important, you see? Okay. See, I don't know why my mind goes there, but you see her feet? I don't see socks, so now I'm wondering if she's wearing panties. I don't fucking know why my mind puts a link. It's like, huh? That's why women don't like men. I don't know if... know if I'm the only way, but I was like, I put weird things together, and I'm like, huh? It's like if they wear the leopard jacket, I'm like, oh, they're wearing those fucking tiger panties. What the fuck am I thinking? The leopard spot ones. Oh, shut up. I gotta stop being honest. With the way you're building this up, I'm getting kind of scared. My intuition, thank you, Joel. That song's in my head now. Seems to be on the mark. The mood is pretty heavy. He looks pretty pissed off. He's like, what the fuck? It's like you make him think he gets mad. Humanity is extinct. Maybe that wasn't just a joke. She's about to tell us the gravity of our current situation. Seriously, are you wearing panties? Here's my conjecture regarding this current world of ours. It's about time for us to face this inexplicable phenomenon head on. Fun time's over. I was hoping she'd say the fucking word and she didn't. Are you familiar with the Balashika incident? What is that, in India? What is that word? Is that... It kind of like reminds me of a word from India. I don't know what that is. I've never heard that one. None of you are saying a fucking word. Why do I have to say it? Yeah, I do. Balashika, right? It's pretty well known. I don't fucking know. Fuck you. I don't fucking know what it is. What is it? I'm not going to keep saying a word. What is it? Balashika! There's a pretty big issue on the internet for a while. What? Huh?
ロシアのモスクワ州バラシハで13歳の少年とその母親が行方不明になった。
In 1988, Balashika City, Moscow, Russia, a 13-year-old boy and his mother went missing.
警察が捜索するも痕跡が不自然なほどに見つからず未解決事件になっていた。
Despite searches by the police, there were unnaturally absolute... That's what it says. There were unnaturally absolutely no traces of their disappearance, and the case went cold.
しかし、それから1年が経ち、近くの森の中で少年の方が見つかった。
A year after the disappearance, they found the boy in a nearby forest.
いや、正確に言えばそれは違う。彼はもう少年と呼べる姿ではなかった。
Or rather, he couldn't really be called a boy anymore.
白髪頭で髭を長く伸ばし、まるで不老者のような格好だったらしい。
What? Hang on. Alright, his hair had turned white and had a long... And he had a long beard, like some kind of homeless old man.
それでも、どうしてその初老の男性がその少年だったと分かったかといえば、
They had only found out that it was the missing boy.
彼が自らそう名乗ったというのと、DNA 鑑定で確かに同一人物と判定が出たからだ。
Because he named himself as such, which was confirmed by a later DNA test.
彼は自分の年齢が分からなくなっていたが、検査から60歳前後であることが判明した。
He no longer knew his own age, but he was deemed to be around 60 years of age, based on tests. That's fucking weird.
母と二人、誰もいないバラシハで生きていた。
God damn, he doesn't have to say that word at all. My mother and I lived in Balashika. Oh, lived in a Balashika that had no one else inside. Lived in a? What the fuck?
彼が言うには、ある日突然、周囲から誰もいなくなり、母と二人、世界に取り残されてしまったらしい。
From his testimony, he and his mother had found themselves in a world where everyone else had suddenly disappeared.
周囲はある程度行くと、
So they age in this world, oh shit.
隔てられており、それを破ることはできそうにもなかった。
After traveling some distance, they found some sort of a mirror. They found a sort of mirror wall that imprisoned them, and they couldn't find a way to break through it.
仕方なく、母と二人で誰もいないバラシハで生活し、50年ほどが経過。という話だ。
Trying to hide a yawn, sorry. Left without any other choice, he and his mother lived in that deserted Balashika for about 50 years. That's what it was about. Yeah, this game's kind of boring, but I want to see if I like it. We'll see if it grows and see what it is. I don't know. I literally tried to look it up and people didn't even play it, so I want to see what it is. A mirror wall.
Ah, so da yo. Kono sekai wa moshikashite Barashiha jiken to onaji nan janai ka tte omotteru.
Does nobody wear socks? Oh, she's wearing them. Okay. Yes, indeed. This world we are in might be the same as in the Balashika incident, but oh, that is what I'm thinking.
Ya, chotto matte kure.
No, wait a minute here. Hold on.
それってオカルトだろ?
Really? That's all you had? That's clearly some crazy supernatural occult shit right there. Or shinibbles. I'm trying to make up a word like Markiplier. Shut up.
現実にありえないからオカルトなんだろ?
Bullshit. I was expecting to go a lot longer than... Shut up, ladies. It's gotta be something supernatural, because that can't possibly be real.
Sakurai-kun. それは違うよ。
Okay, I felt like they caught me looking at her, because they turned and looked at... Okay. That actually is a really cool addition that they do that, because that really fucked with me. I was like, huh? Because I noticed right away when she looked at me. That's pretty cool. Sakurai-kun, that's where you're wrong. You're wrong, bitch.
現実にありえないからオカルトなわけじゃない。科学的説明がつかないからオカルトなんだよ。
Something isn't supernatural because it can't happen in real life. It's supernatural because it's beyond what science can explain. Oh, that makes sense. I still don't think we know what things are. Because, like, the ghost thing that the ghost hunters are looking for, I think there's just a ton about this planet we just don't know. We still see storms we didn't even know this planet was capable of producing. Like, I just don't think we know. I just don't think we know. I've been picked up by invisible forces that are not there. I don't know, man. I've been picked up and carried. So it's not, and I never fucking did hallucinogenics, so I don't care what you believe. I know what I went through, man. Same thing, right? I've been picked up from my bed, and I've been picked up when I fell. So how are you gonna explain that? I should have hit the floor. I was flying. It's like It was weird. It wasn't like flying. You didn't get like wind. It was like someone carried me across the room and put me down gently. And I mean it. I fell on one side of the room and I landed on the other side of the room. Never, ever will anyone explain. I was a kid. There's no fucking way I did drugs or anything. Same thing, right? But, to be fair, as a kid, I did have a medical condition, so I don't know. One that the doctors never figured out. I think it was stress, because I found out about death and I scared myself. But basically, I had stomach pains like you wouldn't believe, went into shock. And literally, that's why I'm the way I am now. You don't understand how much stress fucks your body up, dude. It's insane, and you have control over it. You don't have to be that way. Just find something today that you look forward to, and focus on getting to that thing. And just enhance the happiness each day. Find something else to look forward to. And keep changing your positive thoughts. Instead of waking up and going, man, I feel like shit. Wake up and go, I feel pretty good. And keep doing it and keep doing it sooner or later. It's not really a fake it till you make it. It works. The mind remembers and it gets stuck in this habit. You can break it. Not at all. Not in the slightest. Science is merely what we can manage to record of our world. Plus, I always did, like, research, because I went through depression and all kinds of shit. And I didn't believe depression was a thing. I think it's more like deficiencies all. I don't know, when I keep up on vitamins and stuff and exercise, I feel fine. Depression's such a stupid, fucked up thing. And 90% of the time, it's because of how other people make you feel. It's not how you truly feel, because trust me, if I'd have went through what I tried to do years ago, I'd be nothing because I'd be dead, but if I could have felt, I would have been pissed at myself. You know what I mean? I'm so glad I didn't do it. Try to make sure that these are feelings you feel and not feelings you're feeling because someone else makes you feel like shit. I know that's hard to differentiate, but always start with the environment and work around. That way you know where the problem lies and then you can work on it. But it's not everything. Anything more is just outright scientific arrogance. Seriously, I just keep thinking that I kind of got like, I guess, side titties, because that was on my face, and that touches her titties a lot. That's what the fuck I'd be thinking right now. I'm so, this conversation is boring. Regardless, science can help show hints of what could be.
Bermuda Triangle. Agatha Christie's 空白の 11日間. Kinross 事件. Mary Celeste 号. 日本の 一家 消失 事件.
The Bermuda Triangle. Motherfucker. The Bermuda Triangle. Agatha Christie's 11 missing days. I was starting to get into that Agatha stuff. Let's look at that again. Kinross. The Mary Celeste. Entire families in Japan disappearing. Holy shit.
一応
You could pin some sort of scientific explanation for all of them. So you're saying that the Balashika incident could actually have happened? That I am. The fact of the matter is that we're all in the very same unthinkable situation of being in a closed-off world as we speak. Even someone who only believes what they see has no choice but to accept this. See, now I'm wondering if she's wearing panties. So it's just my mind. Okay, now I'm wondering if everybody's wearing underwear. Okay, stop. Goddamn brain. Though I was skeptical and voiced by my doubts towards Tegoku, she shot back with the cold hard facts.
まあ、安心してよ。バラシハ事件については僕ちょっとだけ詳しいんだ。 Well, relax.
I know just a thing or two about the Balashika incident. My little sister looked into it too. Oh, that's great. I'd expect nothing less from the genius sisters. God damn, you have a deep voice. I thought we were in high school. How the fuck old are you, dude? Everyone in Yuria-chan's family is pretty much a genius. Is it carried down? Because my dad's kind of dumb. But he did alcohol abuse. Fuck you. He's not a dumb guy. Just does dumb things, I guess. Don't they say that about all eccentrics, though? I don't know, man. I definitely am eccentric. I find that out every day. Just by the fact that people, like, stare at me like, what the fuck's she doing? I'm like, really? I just don't care what people think. I'm just comfortable with me, I guess. I had to face me. You know what I mean? I had to deal with who I became and the choices I made. Some people, I guess, don't face themselves. Tengoku smiles at Yu's praise for her, then continues to explain. My sister refers to this closed-off space as the Chronos world. Time? Chronos is time, right? Chronos world? I hear that name a lot, in games and stuff. Really? That's how you're trying to be, like, intellectual and stand out to the scientist? Stand out to the fucking scientist here, so... Games and stuff. Games and stuff, girl. No. Touch my penis. I think he's trying to impress her. The name of a god or something. It is a god, as much. Go on. Hit it. Indeed, since you're trapped in a world where time seems to be frozen, she named it after the Greek god of time, Nipples. Nippleitis. So, Tengoku, goddamn, is it possible for us to get out of here safely? I said goddamn because what that person said sounded really hard to say. About the Balashika incident, how exactly did the guy manage to get back to the real world? He may have lived here for 50 years in Cronus's world, but he definitely did get back home. There's already a precedent, which means all hope isn't lost, true? Right, he managed to get back, so that means we can get back too, right? Yes, it is possible. Then come on, let's go. How'd he do it? It's weird, they actually painted the eyes in proper now. I guess it's just that one scene they didn't expect you to look there. Alright, well, at least they aren't lazy. They just probably didn't think anyone would do that in that one scene. I hit X, dude. In the Balashika incident, the boy was able to return to the real world thanks to his mother's death. What? That's another bad joke, right? According to my sister, Chronos World occurs because of a certain trigger. Once that certain objective is fulfilled, the world will close all on its own. In other words, we need to find what created the Chronos world and get rid of it, or created this Chronos world and get rid of it. And what is that? What the fuck's going on now? Hang on, is there something to hear? Because I'm hearing a weird noise, is there something to see? And it stopped. Shit. I wanted to see if something was creating that sound. Damn it, if I missed it, you can tell me in the comments. Take a look there, everyone, and points at her vagina. No, what are we pointing at? What? Okay. Oh, it says on the fucking building, I am dead who killed me. Okay, that's pretty fucking creepy and cool as shit to actually experience in VR. It took me, and I'm like, where the fuck are they looking? And then I look, and I'm like, oh, that was kind of neat. This thing has some cool ideas. At least they thought it would be fun in VR. They made something fun. I'll give them that. Oh, trophy. That shit scared the fuck out of me. Okay. They haven't gotten one yet. I was like, what the fuck's that? Chronos End. I'm hoping that's chapter one and not the end, because this game was kind of expensive. Oh, are you serious? Okay, this theater mode for this is awesomely thought out. Is this based on a fucking anime too? Punch him. Punch her. I don't know what's going on. Hey, what? Hey, come here. Say, I don't have an arm or anything. So the one who choked me is the one who created this void, huh? Okay, the game is getting interesting, I'll give him that. Virtual figurine mode has been unlocked. Okay, that's kind of cool. Go away. How do you mean? Oh, I was gonna say it goes away on its own. I was like, what? Oh, fuck's yeah. Huh. Oh. Why is it on the. Alright, yeah. So it was on the wrong hand. Right there. Keep the autosave just in case. You never know. You need a backup. Oh, man. Hang on, I've never seen some of these people from the back. Shut up. You're in a mine. You're in a guy's head. I don't care. She's still my favorite. Okay. From looks. I don't know these people yet. I'm enjoying the characters, though. I actually... This kind of hooked me. I'm going to end it here. This is a very good point to end. And find out what's left. Look at the trophies. I'm feeling like this is going to be a big game. I'm also feeling like it's based off an anime. Because that was a lot of thought to it. That's cool. I like the idea of just creating that up there. So, that's where the dude choked me. So, I'm guessing the dude... that we didn't talk about like an asshole is the key to all of this. That's my guess as to what's going on right now. I told you I'm trying to get into this. My little jokes and stuff are just for me. I'm just trying to have fun and share stuff with you. I hope you enjoy, and I will catch you guys in the next episode. Take care. Bye.